never did the edges, getting sweating on my blowout. Sweating on my press, this trick about to go off. Mad cause I'm so fresh, fresher than you. I'm fresher than you. Fresher than you.
Peace up, A-Town Dad.
Yeah, yeah. Okay. Let's go.
Nice.
to meet them, but I hope I never see them again. I know it breaks your heart. Moved to the city in a broke down car. 4 years, no calls. Now you're looking pretty in a hotel bar. And I can't stop. No, I can't stop. So, baby, pull me closer in the backseat of your Rover that I know you can't afford. Bite that tattoo on your shoulder. Pull the sheets right off the corner of the mattress that you stole from your.
Good evening, everyone, and welcome to Hazleton area. Tonight is night one of three. It's the Anthracite Middle School playoffs. Paul Ball alongside the coach, Rich Salonis. And coach, last year we had such a great time calling these games for these fine young athletes here. Nice crowd on hand here for game number one. Last night we got snowed out as 12 inches of snow fell over the Hazleton area. You down in Williamsport got nothing. I saw a shiny sidewalk and everything down there.
I can't believe it. I shook my head. I got up this yesterday morning, and of course the obligatory 2-hour delays, and I said I have to send this to Paul. As you saw, and you know I'm not embellishing, nothing. It was all gone and melted by 10 o'clock. I sent you a second picture. The sun was out, and then driving up here today, once I hit Milton, then it started to change, and I just kept shaking my head when I came into Hazleton today. I'm like, holy cats, you guys got crushed.
Yeah, we got hammered. My backyard, I have a table on the deck. It showed you. It looked like a birthday cake. So last night's games on Tuesday were postponed till Thursday. So tonight we will have two girls' games. Tomorrow night we will have two boys' games, and then the winners will play on Friday. And then, Coach, we are hoping that the Lady Cougars win tonight up in Pittston against Holy Redeemer, because the Wyoming Valley Conference Finals are Saturday. So this can be the first of 4 days and nights here at the Hazleton area here. Tonight, the Hazleton Lady Mounts, the Castle, is at 12-4, are going to take on the Lady Eagles of Valley, and they are 13-3. They both split their meetings during the year. And, Coach, we got the starting lineups. And since you got your pronunciation guide, I'm going to let you read them off.
All right, well, who would you like me to start
with? Let's start with the Mounts from the,
all right,
the Castle.
From the Castle, you are a navy blue and white clad Mounts.
Just like the old Hazleton, yep, uniforms.
Number 3, Anna Jimenez. Number 5, Lorette Soriano. You want me to do the whole roster or just the starters?
No, we'll do the starters.
Okay, number 11, Mia Luna. Number 13, Ashley Coelho. Number 14, Jaden Jones. 24, Wild Dallas Castro. And 25, Celine Betances will be your starting five for the Mounts. And for your Valley Eagles, number 3, Bella Walk. Number 11, Jeanette Veliz. Number 22, Gia Daganero. 24, Chloe Cannon, and 25, Lauren Shaddy.
Yeah, it should be a good game here. And in the nightcap, we have Drums taking on Freeland. Drums, coach, is 16-0, taking on the 8-8 Freeland. But you know what? Last year we saw an upset in the first round, so don't let the records fool you, as the Heights Terrace boys defeated, I believe it was Freeland in that
first
round.
That's correct, they did.
Year. And went on to win the championship.
Yep, led by J.J. Lantigua and a couple other people.
Mr. Lopez.
Yep, and they're back again, I believe, for another go of it. But like you said, we'll have them tomorrow. And what would it be if we didn't wish everyone a very happy Valentine's Day? And I put the M in there on purpose.
Well, Coach, we will get a picture tonight as we are both dressed in our sport coats. I have my red coat on. I look like I should be working at a Holiday Inn. And we will get our Valentine's Day picture out for everyone to make fun of.
Yeah, how about it? I don't think there's going to be very many people viewing this guy's Valentine's picture.
All right, hey, let's turn it down to the public address announcer for tonight's starting lineups.
Learning experience and opportunities for personal growth for the participants. Sportsmanship, the only missing piece is you. Now for tonight's starting lineups. First for the visitors, representing the Lady Mountaineers, number 14, Jaden Jones. Number 13, Ashley Quello. Number 24, Will Dallas Castro. Number 25, Celine Bettens. And number 11, Mia Luna. The Lady Mountaineers are coached by Ryan Wilner. They come into tonight's contest with an overall record of 12-4. Now, representing the home team on the scoreboard, the Valley Eagles. Number 22, Gia Doganero. Number 11, Jeanette Velez. Number 24, Chloe Cannon. Number 25, Lauren Shaddy. And number 3, Bella Walk. The Eagles are coached by Sean Malone and assisted by Christy Welch. Our officials for tonight's contest, Chad Obert, Joe Hamanko Sr., and Tyler Kowalczyk. Ladies and gentlemen, if you are able, please rise and remove your caps. Veterans, please salute as we honor America. Our national anthem will be sung by Valley Elementary Middle School's own Savannah Klingeman.
Oh, say, can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming, and the rockets regular, the bombs burst.
Of the national anthem by that young lady.
Absolutely, well done. I'll
try to get her name a little bit later on as I missed it. So we are set to get underway here. Winner will play the first game Friday night. Loser, it's time to go home, coach.
Absolutely, to playoff time. One and done.
Batonsis will jump for the castle. I hope I pronounced that right.
Yep, and look to your right. There he is, out of nowhere.
From under the bleachers, Chad Obert will throw the ball up, and the tip is controlled by the Eagles. Up ahead to Walk. Walk inside. Nice block there by Will Dallas Castro. And they're off and running here, coach. A little hard off the back iron is Luna. Now, much bigger court here than these girls are used to playing on.
I got here early and saw them all looking up at the scoreboards, and they were enjoying themselves, that's for sure. And what a thrill to get a chance to play on the court, and hopefully future Lady Cougars for Coach Gavio.
Inside pass, now over to the elbow, swings it back out. Nice pass inside to Velez, tries to get it back out, now back out again. Eagles very patient, what a shot. And then back over to Walk, and poked away, and it'll stay here with the Eagles, so.
A good defensive hands by Mia Luna to get in there and whack that away.
Swings it back over top of the key. Is Walk.
Luna.
She's trapped there. Luna with that suffocating defense. Now drives to the basket. Hard up the glass. Up and in.
Chloe Cannon. For the Valley Eagles, start things off. A little bit of token pressure.
Just like your father used to lay them in.
Really?
We interviewed him last year, Sarge. Yep.
There's a runner, not good. Ripped down by Jeanette Villiers.
And over to Walk. Walk now across the timeline. Pass up high to Cannon. Chloe puts it on the hardwood and dribbles it off her foot, picks it back up, back over to Wall. Jumper from the foul line is good.
Oh, and the bank is open late tonight for the Eagles.
By Shaddy. Luna will run the point for this nice crossover. Luna for three, line drive no good, rebounded by Cannon. And we got some steps there.
She knew where she wanted to go with the ball, and she thought about it. Then she didn't think about it, but her feet thought about it. So.
Well, I'll tell you what, like I said, this is a much bigger court. So you're going to see mistakes like that. On a lot of these courts that are very small.
4-0, Valley Eagles.
Oh, yeah, we're having a little technical difficulty with our scoreboard. So we will let you guys know the score.
Ball, that shot hit the structure.
3:38 to go in the first quarter, Rich. We'll give them the time also.
All right.
Until we're back up and running.
Bella Walk bringing the ball up the court for the Valley Eagles.
3 minutes, 30 seconds to go in the first quarter. Valley up 4-0.
And their trademark green and white.
Bounce pass to the elbow. Now back out to Walk just inside the three-point line. Is no good in the rebound by Jaden Jones. And up ahead to Luna. Luna running the court, hard off the glass, up and in.
I'll tell you what, Mia Luna's got some nice speed. You saw it a little bit earlier with her suffocating defense side to side, but she's also got some vertical speed to her as well. And it makes it a 4-2 game with 3:12 left to go in the first period. Crowd steadily filing in.
Oh, yeah.
Remember what we had last year.
Yeah, you'll see that this will be probably the lowest attended night. Until everything gets going here. It's still a little icy, some of the side streets and that, but we'll have a nice crowd on hand here by the time the 7 o'clock game is, and then tomorrow night and Friday night will be packed here. Here's a poke away.
That's Luna again. Very active defensively.
Up ahead to Shaddy. Shaddy's pass over to Cannon. Cannon puts it on the hardwood. Back over to Doganero. Walk again, blew out a tire.
Good anticipation by Luna. She's got another steal.
And she'll go to the line.
Well, she looks pretty confident, doesn't she?
Yeah, she handles the ball nice.
Good ball
four
player.
4-2 here with 2 minutes and 39 seconds to go in the first quarter. Paul Bo alongside the coach, Rich Lonis. Thanks for spending your Wednesday night with us here at Hazleton area. Hazleton girls out to a 7-2 lead over Redeemer up in Pittston, coach. We will keep you updated all night long.
So far, so good, ladies.
Segment on the way is nothing but the bottom of the net, and it's 4-3. Luna has all 3 points. Overhead to Cannon. Cannon crosses over, right-handed dribble. Picks up her dribble, now throws it down to the corner. Doganero swings it over. And that gets it to roll.
Gia with the basket for the Eagles to double their lead.
No, that was Cannon again.
What is Cannon?
Yep. Give her four. There's a pass stolen by Shaddy. And up ahead to Valdez and a whistle.
They're going to get Mia for a body check there along the boards.
2:07 to go in the first quarter, 6-3. Valley leads it. We will keep you posted here as getting through our technical troubles. And a substitution into the game, number 21. Yadrilaz Martinez. And there's a steal by Luna again. Just throws a little short, but again, and
Bella walking the ball up the court.
1:55 to go, clock moving first quarter, 6-3. Valley leads a very evenly played quarter. Both teams feeling each other out, as we said. They split their meetings during the regular season. Shaddy with the ball now picks it up over to Cannon. She's been lights out. Jumper is short. And Walk tries to run it down, but it's on the line. It would be a turnover.
And she got caught in no man's land there, wondering whether to touch it or not, and ended up going forward at the last minute, but the ball went out of bounds. It's going to be the Mounts' possession.
There's a steal. Oh, nice pass.
Oh, wonderful job.
Up and in. Cannon again.
Person, yep.
Must be the pink shoes, coach.
Must be. Valley Eagles, good ball movement on that possession. Allows them to go up 8-3.
1:17 to go here in the first quarter.
Paul, is our monitor fixed for the score? And Valley currently with 1:17 left. Oh, we have a turnover off of Luna, and that's going to go back to the Valley Eagles. We've got the 5-point lead with 1:16 left and the ball underneath the basket.
Over to Cannon again. Mid-range jumper is blocked. And here comes the Castle, 8-3. Jumper is good by Lizzie Garcia. That's a nice jumper.
Nice jump shot by Liz, if you are correct.
We are under 1 minute to play here. 8-5, Cannon on the breakaway. Chloe, a little jump stop there. Can't get it to fall, and quick whistle for the jump ball, and it'll be the Castle's ball. And that's something that'll drive a coach nuts is a call down. That's a walk.
Yeah, they got
a foul.
It could have gone either way. She didn't really give Mia a whole lot of space when she caught the ball, but nonetheless, they called the travel instead of the foul. And either way, it'll drive one of the coaches crazy.
Yep. Ball poked away again. There's Luna again. 39 seconds to go, and
well, she's quick.
Again. And she is. And she's tall.
She is.
We don't have the heights for the girls here, but she's tall. Jaden Jones coming back into the game. She's a returning player from last year's team. I remember her. You guys are wondering about the Hazelton girls. They're up 11-4 over Redeemer in the first quarter. Keep you updated all night long. We got a timeout in the court?
We do.
We got a timeout. We'll keep it right here, Coach. 30-second timeout. 8-5. So what are your impressions so far, Coach?
Well, I like the way Valley's moving the ball. They're patient. They're trying to run some type of an established offense. And Cannon has been lights out so far. Shaddy has played well. But I really like the Mia Luna for the Castle. She's definitely the queen of the Castle here so far in the first quarter. I mean, she's exhibited a lot of things. She can handle the ball. She can run. She can shoot. She seems to have very good court awareness as well.
I think in order for them to win this game, they got to run. And that's where their game is. They're not much of a half-court team. They want to run. Now they're in a 3-2 zone. Very odd.
Yeah, it looks like it is, but Loon is pressuring the ball, so could be one of those combination zones. So
could be a box minus one, right?
There you go.
Walk is tied up again, and we're going to have another jump ball.
Yeah, and that's Luna again getting her hand in to force another jump ball. And now Valley's going to choose to pressure here with just over 20 seconds left.
Here comes Luna across the timeline, right-handed dribble. Tries that bullet pass inside to Will Dallas.
Yeah, she had a nice idea, but Jeanette Veliz had a different story. 11.2
seconds ago. Watch somebody pop out here for the three. But they have a huge height advantage in there. Inside, nice pass. Off the window, no good. And again, up and in.
Good job by Celine Batances there to get the follow-up, Paul. And don't look now. We got a close one here.
And there is your horn as one quarter is in the books here. After one, Valley leads it 8-7. Let's take a quick break. We'll be back for the second quarter.
Let's hear it for the Lady Mount cheerleaders.
All right, welcome back. Here's some stats for the first quarter. Valley, 8 points, 4 of 9 from the field, 5 turnovers, 4 rebounds, and 3 steals. For the Castle, 3 of 7 from the field, that's 43%. They've missed 2 threes, 1 or 2 from the charity stripe, 5 turnovers, 3 defensive rebounds, 1 offense, 1 block, and 1 steal. As we start quarter number 2, it's a 1-point ball game.
Well done again by Christian and Kevin. We appreciate their work. And in between the break, Mr. Boa had a chance to say a quick hello to Sammy Guzman and Luke Gennaro, who were here. Asked them if everybody's healthy. They gave me the thumbs up.
5:38 to go here in the half, 8-7.
And the boys will make their next appearance in the district playoffs, correct?
Correct. And that will be, I believe, next Wednesday. I have them all written down at home. I think the boys play before the girls.
Fouls on Lady Mount number 13, Ashley Quello. That is her first. Team first this quarter.
The boys will have to play the opening round, the 3-6 game.
Correct.
Which will be against Valley West. That is set. Valley West will be the 6th seed, and Williamsport will play Del Valley in the 3-4 game. Winners will play Wilkes-Barre, and Scranton will have the byes. So if Hazleton does win their first game, they will play.
Now into the game for the Eagles, number 12, Layla Walk.
But their first game will be here.
First game is here. That's the only game that'll be here. Unless there's an upset.
Correct. Ooh. Little disagreement there, as Mia thought she got all ball. The official saw it a different way. Early on into the second period, 5:12 left. Valley holding on to an 8-7 lead.
Fouls on Lady Mountaineer number 11, Mia Luna. That is her third.
That's
team
her
first
third foul.
That's something.
Sorry, correction. Team second this quarter.
So we'll see if she takes a seat.
She doesn't appear to be.
No. And at the line is, who's at the line, coach? That Doug and Arrow?
I think it may be, but the ponytail's in the way. I'm sorry. I know it's yep. 22, yep. Doug and Arrow. G is at the line. There we go. You know, those ponytails, I never gave any thought to them until you said something about that a while ago.
I blame that on our forefathers. Here comes Cannon, right-handed dribble down that right wing. Nice pass, lays it up and in.
So Velez for two.
Velez lays it up and in, 10-7. Valley with 4:57 to go. Here comes Luna, no problem breaking the press. Missed a bunny there. Kicks it back out, Cannon gets a hand in the passing lane. And it looks like it's going to be.
Yeah, they're gonna get shaddy, I believe.
Yeah, it's gonna be.
On a reach.
Yep. Oh, you got a foul on that? They called a foul.
Fouls on Eagle number 25, Lauren Shaddy. That is her second. Team first this.
4:39 to go here in the half. It's 10-7.
Now Mia takes a seat. So far from what we've seen, she's much too valuable to lose here.
Nice. Underneath there, and one, count it.
It's good.
Jaden Jones with the bucket and a chance to tie it up.
14 for the Mounts, puts it in. She's going to go to shoot and one and get that possible three-point play. How?
The old-fashioned way.
Pleasure to be here on Valentine's night.
Yeah, who else would I rather spend my Valentine's Day with, coach, than you?
Well, thank you very much. Yeah.
Hard off the glass, no good. Rebound by Valdez and Velez, excuse me. And that is in travel.
Yeah, Jane Jones jumped in front of her and forced her to shuffle her feet.
4:30 to go, 10-9. Garcia to trigger the inbound. Almost threw it away. And in the hands of Quelo. Inside. Turnaround jumper, no good. And a rebound by Shaddy. Picks up her dribble, though. And in the hands of Walk. Walt now across the timeline, right-handed dribble, picks it up, bounce pass over to Shaddy, 4:10 to go, three ball on the way, is hard off the back of the iron, long rebound into the hands of Quelo. Quelo on the break, taps the brakes, up
nice
and in.
Nice job, well done. About half a coast to half a coast there. And Castle, I believe, has its first lead of the game at 11-10.
First lead of the game with 3:51 to go, clock moving in the first half. Cannon. Right-handed dribble, puts it on the floor. Crosses over to the left, but off her foot, and she lost it. Substitution into the ball game for the Eagles. That is number 12, Layla Walk. And Chloe's going to take a break here.
Yes, we have Layla and Bella Walk. Bella number three.
The Walk of Life. There you go. There's a nice steal there by Bella. Over to Kayla. Jumper is blocked by Jones. Jones having a fantastic first half.
Yeah, I'm going to say Gia Dognero knocked that out. The ball's going to go back to Hazleton. Mia Luna back in the game.
3:25 to go. Well, I think she's just too valuable to the team. Puts it on the floor, and we're going to have a jump ball again. Another quick whistle.
Yeah, Chad Obert right on top of it.
.3:15 to go here. Tries to get it in, and Velez just picks it away.
And they were looking for batons, as she had to put a little bit more air under it.
Yeah, they got a huge height advantage. They just got to use it underneath.
They do.
Shaddy with the ball over to Walk. And another jump ball. Hey, before we forget, Coach, I want to thank Damian for helping us out, get his rosters. Kathy Brogan helped me out yesterday, sent me a whole bunch of stuff. I kept bothering her, asking her what the schedule was. I wanted to make sure we had everything. But everybody here in Hazel area, you know, doing a fantastic job to help us out as always, and that does not go unnoticed. Trust me.
No, much appreciated. It's so nice.
Cannon jumper hard off the glass. No good, ball batted around like a pinball there. And in the hands of Les. Batances just steps on the brakes there, and I'll tell you what, she's a presence inside, Coach.
She is. So it's such a pleasure to work with. With people who care and make it so pleasant, and it's just wonderful when everybody rows the boat in the same direction.
You must have a new partner coming that I don't know about. 2:40 to go in the half. .11-10. As you see, the bigger court is definitely a factor here. We got a timeout here. You got him, you might as well use him. 30-second timeout. Let's get an update from Pittston.
All right, let's do that.
Well, at the end of one quarter, Hazleton 20, Holy Redeemer 8.
Well, let's keep it going, ladies. You got three more quarters to go.
Caitlin Bindis leading the way with 7 points. Sophia Benyo with 4. And Sophia Schultz with 9. Excuse me, I didn't see that.
Excellent.
Excellent there. We're big fans, so we have interest. Bobby, girls up 28, second quarter. Let's keep it going, ladies. Long way to go, as we know, Coach.
Yep.
Yeah, you can't move on that. It wasn't a basket. Yep. That's going to be a travel.
I don't think Mia knew that. Now she does, a teaching point.
Walk, mid-range jumper, no good. Panzabella. No good again, ball tipped around, and that was tipped, so we'll not be backcourt. We got...
Well, it's either going to be Mia or it's going to be Quelo.
Yep, Quelo with a hip check.
So, you know, I know you're saying how Mia is valuable. That's obvious, but
I'll tell you what. Yeah.
They're playing with fire with her in it because she's not backing down either. She could have gotten one there.
And they still have her in. Well, she was in the middle of the zone now. Gannon, no good. Up goes Betances. And that's another jump ball.
Yeah, her and Gia went at it pretty good there.
2:06 to go, 11-10. Castle leads Valley with only 2 points this quarter.
We've been in a scoring drought.
We have been. Well, you know what? I don't think Valley's very deep. I'm looking who has their uniforms. Only too deep with their warm-ups off. So they're going to make go with their starters. Nice pass. Bastances at the doorstep
well,
up and in.
I'll tell you what. Mia sees the floor well in Bastances. And a steal by Luna.
Yep. I'd slow it down here. Yeah, head fake. Drives. Oh, boy. Ball slid around. She runs it down again. So over the court. Three ball on the way, way downtown.
It's going to be chased down by Bella Walt.
1:33 to go here in the first half. Mid-range jumper is short. I thought that was good. They got a break. Quelo. Up ahead, lays it. Oh, missed the bunny.
Hey, that was a big basket, too. They're giving a 5-point lead, and they're in the midst of everything again is Mia Luna.
I'm starting to summon my drowning pool here and let the bodies hit the floor.
Well, it certainly has been an aggressive, in a good way.
All right, DeVito got the scoreboard working. We're back in business.
And another tie-up with Mia and Jaden Jones at the forefront for Hazleton, and the arrow possession's going to go their way.
Seconds to go. Mia with the ball again. Right wing extended there. Passes it over.
Nice pick.
Launch
set.
A three.
And it's good.
Right down the rabbit hole, coach.
And I'll tell you what, you got to give credit there to Quelo for setting a nice screen for her. And she came right around it, and it was nothing but net. 6 points for Luna.
6-point lead. 18 seconds to go. Walk pass inside, and we're going to get a travel light. No, they call the foul.
Yeah, they're going to get Betances for.
Ooh.
Yeah, could have gone another one of those. It could have been a travel or could have been a foul.
Should, it should be on the floor here. There shouldn't be no shooting. No,
then it is.
And Martinez going to trigger the inbound here. Over to Cannon. Back over. Cannon again. That's blocked again by Jones.
And they're going to say off of Cannon. You got 6.5 seconds left here.
Chad's saying he has the shooter here. Betances.
Being harassed.
3 seconds. And that'll end the half here with 1.4 seconds to go.
Adrelius Martinez did a nice job of pressuring the ball down the court and causing that turnover, and that's going to be it, Paul Bowe, for the first half.
So we are at the half, a 9-point second quarter for the Mounts and a 2-point quarter for the Eagles. That's where we stand at 16-10. Interesting first half, very good first half. We're going to have some shootout drills here now in the intermission to help benefit the Booster Club, I believe.
See some of the Cougars on the floor, Luke, Sammy.
I see John Nat down there too, Coach Nat. Well, let's take a break. I'm not sure if we have anybody coming up here for an interview or not, but we'll take a break and we'll be back.
To the heart, I never kissed a mouth that tastes like yours. Strawberries and something more. Oh yeah, I want it all. Lipstick on my guitar. Fill up the engine, we can drive real far. Go dancing underneath the stars. Oh yeah, I want it all. Got me feeling like I wanna be that guy. Till the sunlight cracks when they see.
kiss myself, I'm so pretty. I'm too hot. Call the police and the fireman, I'm too hot. Make a dragon wanna retire, man, I'm too hot. Say my name, you know who I am, I'm too hot. And my band bought that money, break it down. Girls hit you, hallelujah. Girls hit you, hallelujah. Girls hit you, hallelujah. Cause Uptown Funk don't give it to you.
Cause Uptown Funk.
Just watch. Hallelujah. Ooh. Girl, sent you hallelujah. Ooh. Cause Uptown Funk don't give it to you.
Ooh. Cause Uptown Funk don't give it to you.
Cause Uptown Funk don't give it to you.
Saturday night and we in the spot.
Don't believe me, just watch.
Here at Hazleton area, we are at the half. The Castle leading 16-10 for the Castle. 6 points for number 24. Is that right, Coach? 6 points?
That's what they're saying.
I don't think she scored 6 points. I think that's wrong.
That's Valley, Paul.
Oh, I'm looking at the wrong side because my player sheet is backwards. That's Chloe Cannon with
Chloe 6.
That is
Chloe Cannon. She started off.
Yep, and Luna with 6. For the Castle, right. My mistake there. I'm left to right over here, and
that's
it's the
okay.
Other way on the scoreboard. You guys can't see at home, but it was an honest mistake.
It is.
Don't fire me.
We will not be fired.
All right, the Castle, 16 points on 16, 6 of 18 from the field, 1 of 4 from behind the arc, 1 for 3 from the line, 10 turnovers, 6 defensive rebounds, 6 offensive rebounds, 3 blocks as Batons is having a field day underneath, 4 steals for Valley, 5 of 19 from the field, not shooting very well at all. That's only 26%. 0 of 2 from the free throw line. They turned it over, Coach, 11 times, 12 rebounds, and 6 steals.
Thank you, Christian. Great job as always.
5:44 to go here.
A couple of mid-range jumpers. Mid-range jumpers were missed by Valley while Paul was reading the statistics.
Coach, I wasn't. Is it 7 minutes or 6 minute quarters?
Six minutes
for junior. Quarters. I thought I wasn't paying attention at the start of each thing. I thought it was six. So that's a big difference too. 6 point lead, 6 minute quarters. We're going to get another jump ball.
And the arrow is going to go to the castle. The officials being very definitive on quick calls.
And we'll jump it again.
Another jump ball. Well, as you say, be consistent, correct? And I think they've been very consistent.
I'm going to take a sip of water, Coach, every time there's a jump ball.
Don't do that.
I know. I'll be in the, you know where I'll be. Good hands by Luna. And she will take it up the court. Left-handed dribble now over to the right and dribbles it off the back of her shoe.
And she's getting decent pressure by Bella Walk.
5:04 to go here in the third quarter. 16-10, Castle. Thanks for spending your first part of your Wednesday night here. And we got a nightcap here. We got the Drums Girls and the Whippets. The Lady Whippets from Freeland.
One of my all-time favorite.
That's where nicknames. Chubby was a legend at Freeland.
Still is.
Oh, still is, right. I can't believe he didn't come to the game tonight, Coach.
Well.
Shattuck drives, scores.
Yeah, nice bank she shot needed by that. Lauren. She did.
You know, Valley's getting good shots in the paint. They just can't put it in. There's a breakaway there.
I'll tell you, Mia Luna has her head up, got the outlet pass.
That has to be on my all-name team, Will Dallas Castro.
Yeah, Will
I love
Dallas.
It. I love it.
Will Dallas just Will did it. Puts the castle up by 6.
And there's Jones again. Tenacious defense there. Chloe Cannon now with the ball, pass inside, it is tipped into the hands of Betances and back to Luna. Luna, pass down low, again, up again.
That's 2 in a row.
Castro again.
That is well done, and Coach for the Castle giving him the Whippet sign. He wants more motion, he wants to run, as you said.
Coach Ryan Wilner for the Castle.
He wants motion, he wants movement. And pretty soon here, Paul, Valley's going to have to start thinking about maybe upping their tempo a bit.
Well, they are getting one shot.
There's your first sip for another tie-up. Well, as you said, you know, in this type of game with six-minute quarters, an eight-point lead is fairly significant.
The Valley has scored 4 points in the last 9 minutes. That's not good. And there's that height advantage again. Castro on the doorstep, up and in.
Again, third time's a charm, man. That's 3 in a row, correct?
We're going to have a full timeout.
Yeah, Valley's going to be forced to take one as the castle has lowered the drawbridge.
Yeah, they're up by 10 here. Let's take a quick break. We'll be back.
Everybody gets high sometimes, you know. What else can we do when we're feeling low?
All right, we are back here at Hazel area. 10-point castle lead.
Well, I'll tell you, if you're Castro, you're loving the last three possessions, huh?
Yeah. Okay, a lot of people chiming in, Coach, are listening to us here.
Nice rebound for Jeanette Villiers, and she's going to go to the line and shoot two. One of the few second chance opportunities for the Valley Eagles here, as they've been stymied by the Castle.
How about, Coach, we got a listener in Texas tonight. How about that?
Really? Awesome.
Our good friend Terry Galbietti is out in Texas. You know what they say, Coach? Everything's bigger in Texas.
I've heard that.
Yep, she's out there and texting me from Texas, listening to the game. How about that?
So check this out at midcourt if you think they don't respect Mia Luna. Bella Walk was all the way out past the Cougar logo. Just
hands in the face.
Yep, hands in the face, and the ball hadn't even been taken out yet, and she's harassing her up the court.
Gets it just across the timeline. Inside, again, Lesnar tips it away into the hands of Jones. Pass is picked off there by Duganiero.
Hey, they were trying to go to Castro again to make it an even four.
You know, Drums has to be, or excuse me, Valley has to be patient. You know, like I said, a big court, you're down nine. Take your time, one possession at a time. There's a lot of time left.
There is, and...
There is and there isn't.
Yes, and what you're saying is absolutely correct, but I don't know if they can afford to be as patient as they were in the first quarter.
No, but they got to get good shots. They got to get good looks at the basket, and they got to get some rebounds. I mean, the Castle is killing them on the boards. Cannon taps the brakes. Now pass over to Walk. Walk, long corner shot, no good. And
Castro,
a rebound there by Castro again. She's having a quarter. That's going to be a double dribble there. I'll tell you what, Castro can go to the rack quick. She is quick.
She's got no problems putting the bunnies down, let me tell you.
Nope. No lost rabbits there. 2:05 to go in the quarter, 9-point lead. Martinez hard off the glass. Is Velez no good? Rebound by Castro again, up ahead. Luna looking up. And that's Cuello. She's tied up in the corner there. And
they're going to get her for a travel.
1:42 to go into the rapid moving third quarter. Look at Terry just texted me. How about that?
Well,
she said we're the best. I think that's what that says, right?
Yeah, something like that. Something with a couple S's in it.
It says best.
Yeah.
Martinez with the ball, right wing.
Again, the Castle in somewhat of a zone here, forcing Valley to be patient with their entry passes and nowhere to go, really.
Jump ball.
Take another swig.
I can't because I'm already on break down there.
Possession back to the Castle.
1:10 to go here in the third quarter. Here comes Cuello up ahead to Castro. Oh, how did she score that?
Castro says, why not? See if the bank's open from mid-range, and it is. Give her eight.
Cashing in the change.
She may be the leading scorer here.
11-point lead. Valley in a lot of trouble here.
And the rebound, and there she goes.
It's a 4-on-none. Oh, bad pass.
Yeah, I don't think she got everything on it. She wanted to go to Luna, who was out ahead in the race, but couldn't get her the ball.
You know, good defense there by Betances as she just bodied up and made her alter her shot, did not come in contact, and the ball will belong to the Castle.
Alexa Ustanovsky.
They're getting it done on both sides of the ball. I mean, it's plain and simple.
Oh, numbers for the Castle. And there goes Castro again. And it's going to be an opportunity for another three-point play. Castro with 10 points for the Castle, and she's looking to cap off a three-point play here as the Mounties are starting to put some distance between themselves and Valley.
And that one rims out.
But the rebound goes to Castle.
That's Garcia with the ball, and don't look now, the Hazel area girls are up by 1 point, Coach, 38-37, a 15-4 quarter in favor of the Lady Royals, the Holy Redeemer, and they're coming roaring back. Jumper is no good. Rebound by Betances, no good. 7 seconds to go. They're going to have to hurry. And they're going to get a foul with 2 seconds to go.
Yeah, and guess what? That's going to be on Miss Luna. That's her fourth foul. And she really didn't need to do that.
13-point lead, 2 seconds to go. One, and there's your horn. It will not count. And three quarters in the books, Castle leads 26-13. Let's take a break. We'll be back for the fourth.
Let's hear it for the Valley Eagle cheerleaders.
All right, we are back here. Three quarters in the books for the Castle. 11 for 25 from the field, 1 for 4 from behind the arc, 1 for 4 from the free throw line, 17 turnovers, 18 rebounds, 3 blocks and 8 steals for Valley, 6 for 28 from the field. They have not attempted a three-point shot, 1 for 4 from the free throw line, 17 turnovers, 16 rebounds, no blocks, and 9 steals. So we got a one quarter to go here. There we go again, Coach. Nobody down low. Castro missed a bunny this time, but it will stay here.
That's her first miss underneath the basket. She is the only player, I believe, in double figures.
Three ball on the way is hard off the glass. Betances underneath there.
She almost came down with 2 offensive rebounds.
They're going to get a travel there.
Re-entering for the Lady Mountaineers, number 14, Jaden Jones.
5:23 to go here in the ball game. A 13-point lead for the Castle. Three ball on the way is no good. Rebound by Castro, can't put it in. That is short. And Shaddy comes down with the rebound over to Velez. Gonna run the floor. Pull up jumper, no good.
But Betances did a nice job.
Nice defense. And Jones, they're gonna get with the foul, and she'll go to the line to shoot a pair.
I thought Celine did a nice job positioning her body, making that shot.
Fouls on Lady Mountaineer, number 14, Jaden Jones. That is her first.
But then the rebound came back, and Jeanette was persistent, and she's got herself a couple of foul shots coming her way. Which, again, now, if you're Castle, this is the last thing you want to do, is want to be stopping the clock and allowing foul shots.
Second one is no good.
Celine with the rebound to Luna. Luna directing traffic.
Yeah, she got those three quick fouls and shuffles her feet there, no call. Castro's going to launch a three. That's no good. 4:46 to go here, now 4:44 and a whistle. 13-point lead. Valley scored eight in the first. They only have 13, Coach, five over the next two quarters as they are in a shooting slump.
And I think they've had some issues with Castle's height and athleticism in certain positions.
Chatty drives in. Nice pass at the doorstep. Velez,
up Velez for two.
And well done from Chatty to Velez.
Now you see that full court press. Jones breaks it easily. Taps the brakes. Over to Castro, puts it on the ground, or the floor. And there's a steal. Breakaway, that's Walt. A little too hard, Velez with the ball.
Jeanette Velez with the putback.
Yeah, nice job by Velez to get hustling down the court to pick up that miss and turn it into two, and Valley on a little bit of a run.
Yeah, 4 minutes to go, timeout.
30-second timeout, Hazleton.
As the Eagles have picked up the tempo and got themselves back to a 9-point game here.
Boy, I'll tell you what, Coach, it is Hazleton girls game. There
is in varsity girls basketball action, Hazleton area leads Holy Redeemer 38-37 in the third quarter.
Well, you can't get much closer than that.
The last 6 minutes of real time, there has not been a bucket.
Wow. Sounds like there's droughts everywhere, huh?
Yep.
Well, unfortunately, we've seen that happen this year from the Lady Cougars. And
well, they're up three. Caitlin just hit two foul shots. So the drought is over. And here we go here. Castro again running the court. Chatty with the rebound. Up ahead to Velez. Velez puts it on her hip. She scored the last 4 points. Cannon runs down the rebound. Wall, mid-range, no good. That was good from here. I'll tell you what, if the Castle can get a rebound, they got a layup the other way.
Chloe Cannon for two.
Cannon lays it in, 3:32 to go.
And that's her first bucket since the first quarter,
yep,
I think.
Give her eight, lead down to seven. Look at Luna go. Into the corner. Back over to Luna, head fake. Drives around baseline, nice pass. Over to Castro, 3:12 to go. Back out to the top of the key. That is Luna.
Yeah, Coach wants some movement, wants some motion.
Barking signals like an air traffic controller there, directing traffic. Back over, Castro three, that's partially blocked. Castro grabs the rebound and, that was Quaylo with the shot.
There goes Veliz again.
She's fouled, no call. Jones comes down with the rebound and that's gonna be a travel, I think, or are we getting a foul?
There should be a foul there, but we'll see what they call.
240.
Oh, they're going to call the travel.
Now checking in for the Lady Mountaineers, number 15, Liseth Garcia.
And Paul, you're shaking your head. That's not a good sign.
Nope.
Inbound pass broken up by Betances. Jaden outlets it up to Luna. He picks up her dribble.
Yep, back over to Jones, now back over to Luna, 2:25 to go. Luna running one-hander, no good. Rebound by Shaddy.
Yeah, I don't know if that's the shot you want if you're Hazleton because...
Well, that was tipped. You can only get that. I don't know. Velez again, and she is fouled with 2:10 to go.
And it is a 7-point lead.
Fouls on Lady Mountaineer, number 14, Jaden Jones. That is her second foul. Checking in for the Eagles, number 3, Bella Walk.
Yeah, Pass inside to Mwez. Over to Shag, tries to get it over to Cannon, and we'll have a jump ball again, and it'll be Castle ball.
We are right at the 2-minute mark here, and definitely in a position where.
Back into the game for the Lady Mountaineers, number 13, Ashley Quello.
Valley is in striking distance, obviously, only down 7. Foul situation. They've got 5, they've got 4 to give, Paul. They don't have a foul.
That's Quello with the ball. Tries to get it down low to Castro, and they threw it away. They got to be more patient. They're up 7 points.
Yeah,
there's no need to force it.
Well, Walk is absolutely positively following Mia Luna everywhere she goes on the other end and just denying her, won't even let her even attempt to get the ball.
You don't know how to shoot the ball. You're up by 7 points.
Well, we've seen that before, have we not?
Velez, she's been dynamite. Walk partially blocked.
And that was Luna. That could have been her 5th, but she got all ball.
She's had a chance for about 7 fouls. She's just a house of fire there. Fantastic ball player. 7 points.
Re-entering for the Lady Mountaineers, number 14, Jaden Jones.
Well, I'll tell you, it's been a balanced attack for Castle. As we're looking at the scoreboard, they have quite a few girls that have scored.
Yeah. Velez again puts it on the floor, off the window, missed the bunny. Another jump ball. And coach, I remember this very well from last year. Drums uniforms, I cannot see the numbers.
Uh-oh.
They are yellow. I remember that last year.
They are gold and royal blue. Yes, they are.
And they are not outlined in anything.
We'll help you out. Oh, big turnover.
Oh, tries to get it up ahead.
And again, an outlet pass there. I don't know if you needed that. You don't need points if you're a Castle at this.
1:12 to go from the elbow. No good.
At this particular time, big steal by Luna. And she's off and running.
Oh, missed the bunny. Quello at the doorstep can put it in. 54 seconds to go. And that's not much time here in the games like this here on a big court. Full timeout.
Full timeout, Valley.
seconds left to go. We currently have a 7-point game.
Hazel girls up by 5, coach. Kayla Ligoe just hit a 3-pointer. Still has to be late third quarter.
Well, tell me that. Tell me that that's the end result, and I'll be happy.
How much time in the third, Bobby? Do we have any updates in the Hazel game?
Okay, so quick scoreboard update here, if you can see it or not. 3 timeouts remaining for Castle, 2 for Valley. They will also have the possession arrow in their favor, Paul Bowe. Waiting for the fouls to give, but I believe they have 2 to give, if I am correct, before. It's 2 or 3 to give before they put Castle on the line.
Now there's 49 seconds to go. You got a big court here.
Yeah, they have not committed a foul. They've got 4 to give, right?
No,
the rule's the same for junior high?
Yeah. I believe so. I think that's in everything. You got to shoot. Manganiero has to stay here with 42 seconds to go. Valley has to start putting the ball up in the air.
Correct. And Valley has 2 fouls to get. So I'm surprised they weren't a little bit more aggressive defensively there.
Yeah, to rack up those fouls. Cannon has it blocked. And run down there by.
That was Castro, I believe.
Yep.
Oh, and it's going to go.
That was Quello, right?
Oh, it's Kathleen Rogers. You're right, Quello. I was looking at the wrong side. Well.
The basket by Ashley Quello is good. The foul's on Eagle number 25, Lauren Shaddy. That is her 3rd.
That should probably ice it, no?
Well, that was the first 2 points the Castle scored this quarter.
Yeah, they've been.
They haven't scored in 6 minutes, almost 6 minutes. That sounds familiar. Backcourt.
Yeah, Quello is back and forth with it. And again, now, no need to foul at all with just under 24 seconds remaining in the game.
How many teams win with a two-point fourth quarter coach?
Not many. Unfortunately, we've seen that happen a couple times.
What's going to happen here? Cannon, no good. Rebound, Betances. Shaddy again, no good. 12 seconds to go. Rebound, Jones. Gillette's still fighting.
Chloe Cannon for two.
Cannon gets it to fall, and
it's going to be it.
There's your horn, and the Lady Mountaineers will advance to the final.
Congratulations to the Hazleton Lady Mountaineers. They will play in the championship game Friday night at 6 p.m. here at Hazleton Area High School. Congratulations to Coach Wilner and the Lady Mountaineers. Also, an update in varsity girls basketball. Hazleton Area leads Holy Redeemer 51-44 in the fourth quarter.
All right, that is your final here. They're starting the fourth quarter in Pittston. Just started the fourth quarter, Coach. But a good game here for the Castle, and I think, Coach, the height was the difference in this.
Yeah, the height was the difference, and also the emergence of Wild Dallas Castro.
Well,
Celine Betances and Mia Luna, the big three. And then, of course, you had Jaden Jones chipping in. But there were five. There were at least five players that have scored in the game for Castle.
All right. Well, you know, we pick a player in a game, and since they're both local teams, Coach, we've got to do one of each.
Well, I have to go with Luna for Castle.
All right. You're going to go with Luna. I'm going to go with Chloe Cannon, 10 points. Scored six in the first quarter. Also, I'm going to go 1A, Lauren Shaddy. Didn't score a lot, but had a good game on the boards. They were the two bigs there for Valley, and they kept them in the game, but the outside shooting just was not there.
No.
Oh, boy, and I'm looking down here now at the numbers here, and this is going to be a nightmare for calling a game. We'll get our final stats here. Christian's wrapping up, and then we are going to take a break, and then we will be back in about 15 minutes for game number two, the Whippets and the Drums Eagles.
Absolutely.
And Drums 16-0, Coach. We got to wait for the stats. You can't get off yet. You want to go for a break?
I was thinking about a couple other things, and I thought you said we were off. But yeah, the final standings, Drums Tigers undefeated, 16-0, Valley Eagles second, 13-3, the Hazleton Mounts, who we just saw advance, now are 13-4. And then something must have, Freeland must have had the tiebreaker, because them and MMI were tied at 8-8.
All right, for the Castle, 28 points, 12 of 33 shooting from the field, 1 for 8 from behind the arc, 1 for 5 from the free throw line, 23 turnovers. They had 25 rebounds, 4 blocks, and 11 steals. Valley 10 for 43 from the free throw foul line. And that's not going to win you many games, Coach.
Shooting no, it
10
isn't.
For 43. 1 for 6 from the charity stripe, 21 turnovers, 12 steals. So that was it. That's our final score. We're going to take a bit of a break, and then we'll be back in about 10 minutes for game number two.
I'm a rocking boat. I just want to stay afloat. I'm all alone.
Thank you. daddy trying to pick it up like a car. I'm a heap that lights on to it until tomorrow, yeah.
Shady, I can see that you got so much energy.
The way you're twirling up them hips round and round.
There's no reason at all why you can't be there with me.
In the meantime, stay, let me watch you break it down and
the last though.
Champagne. Let's continue tonight. Come on, girl.
what we is. You know what we is. Sometimes you gotta stay in, in. Welcome to my house. Baby, take control now. We can't even slow. Shot of vodka, you know what's in my glass. It's my house, just relax. Welcome to my house, baby. Take control now. We can't even slow down. We don't have to go out. Welcome to my house. Play that music too loud. Show me what you do now. We don't have to go out.
My house.
All of the lights.
Dead. I slapped my girl, she called the feds. I did that time and spent that bread. I'm headed home, I'm almost there. I'm on my way, headed up the stairs. To my surprise, a nigga replacing me. I had to take him to that ghetto university.
All the lights,
top lights, flashlights, spotlights, strobe lights, street lights.
All of the lights, all of the lights.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to our second semifinal Anthracite League playoff game tonight, featuring the Freeland Whippets and the Drums Tigers. The Hazleton Area School District is committed to the sportsmanship goals of the Pennsylvania Interscholastic Athletic Association. All players, cheerleaders, officials, and spectators are expected to assist in the promotion and achievement of good sportsmanship by taking personal responsibility for keeping this contest at a high level of fair, clean, and wholesome competition. We ask that you remember that the purpose of this activity is to provide a positive learning experience and opportunities for personal growth for the participants. Sportsmanship, the only missing piece is you. Now for the visitors on the scoreboard, representing the Freeland Whippets. Number 2, Aliyah Blinar. Number 4, Jalishka Ojeda. Number 14, Abby Williams. Number 12, Sophia Bueso. And number 31, Darielli Caraballo. The Whippets are coached by Todd Smolinski and come into tonight's contest with an overall record of 8-8.
Little Devo action for the Whippets. I love it.
Now for the home team on the scoreboard, the Drums Tigers. Starting for the Tigers, number 1, Jenna Chulock. Number 4, Jordan Kuchme. Number 5, Cambria Yarish. Number 22, Kayla Wysocki. And number 24, Molly Tim Chatton. The Tigers are coached by Marcia Creaney and Sarah Kostick and come into tonight's contest with an overall record of 16-0. Our officials for tonight's contest are Frank Van Ork, Joe Hamanko Jr., and Kevin Fergal.
All right, we are set to get underway. The Drums Tigers taking on the Freeland Whippets, and we will do our best with drums. The numbers are unreadable. I can tell you that right now. You can't see them at all. They are yellow, and they are not outlined in anything, Bobby.
Possibly the worst color to put against white and not outline is either silver or this light gold, and it's... We'll do our best.
And the ball is controlled by drums.
And to boot, Paul, real quick, all of the Tigers have graced us with long ponytails to boot.
Yep. Well, that's Tim Chatton with the ball. Back over. Molly drives baseline, pass off the window, up and in.
Good way to start the game. A nice dribble drive, penetrate and dish off there for the Tigers.
And that's Jenna Chulock with the basket. Steal again, up and in. There's Tim Chatton with her first two of the ball game. And it's important for Freeland to weather that early storm here. You can see the difference in speed from the first game, coach. There's another steal. Nobody home there as it's ran down there by Blanier. And the Whippets try to get it up ahead to Carballo. Taps the brakes. Back over to Blanier. Long three, no good. And a rebound by Drums.
I think it's Chulock. I think it's number one.
Three on the way is no good.
Good battle for the ball between Abby Williams and a Tigress under the board. Possession arrow favoring the Whippets. As we are early on here, with Drums up 4-0. Freeland having some issues trying to get the ball up the court. Ball is stolen by Tim Chatton.
And lays it up and in, coach. Timeout immediately by Freeland, and 6-0 already, and that's the way that Drums offense goes. They are quick. They are fundamentally sound, coached by Marcia Kringy. We know the pedigree there, and they're gonna press you, and they're gonna push you. And for Freeland, like we said, they have to weather the storm. 4:28 to go, about 2.5 minutes in, and they've taken one shot so far.
Correct.
Lady Cougars up 65-64.
Oh.
65-61. Excuse me, coach. My bad.
It's got to be close. It's got to be close to the end.
Yeah, it has to be late in the ball game.
As everyone's got vested interests, obviously, in this game, and as we look out onto the court, the future Lady Cougars that are going to come up and feed the program.
And how about the Lady Cougars game, coach? Mariah Marola, 11 points in this ball game.
Well, that's a good sign.
Coming in, there's some foul trouble.
Now they got to finish the deal, Paul Bowe. They need a win.
Long cross-court pass. Williams. And it's tipped out. Stolen away again by Drums up ahead. That's Tim Chatton again, drives to the rack, can't get it to fall.
Chulock off the steal. Give Chulock four.
I remember her last year. Good ball player. Carballo has it. It's going to be a turnover there. And 3:48 to go in the first quarter, 8-0 Drums. Hey, chatting yo-yos with the ball out there.
Well,
what's the last
looks like it's going to be a good one. Last update I have is 67-61, Cougars with 13.3 seconds left.
Nice drive, and it falls. I believe that was Wysocki on that one.
And we have a final from Pittston. Hazleton, 67. Holy Redeemer, 61.
Big win for the Lady Cougars, 67-61. We'll see you all Saturday.
Absolutely.
We'll break that down at halftime. We'll go through the scores now. We got a halftime guest coming up, Bobby. Got Scott Burkhart coming up, coach of the Drums Boys.
Another coast-to-coast basket for Tim Chatton, and give her 6 points, Paul, and we're going to get a turnover for Freeland, and Drums is just having their way at the moment.
There by Williams. Again, jump ball.
And it is a tie-up, and it's going to stay with the Tigers. Kayla Wysocki inbounding the ball. I did get a look at the double twos there when the ponytail went back and forth. So that's Blanyar out for the whip. It's showing some good speed. Maintains possession.
Trying to get a good shot here. Trying to set something up. Jumper is no good by Ojeda.
Bueso had that rebound, but again, it's taken away. Drum's quickness is very evident.
Nice crossover. Lays it up and in.
I believe that's Tim Chatton again, correct?
That is.
And she makes things happen. There she is again, almost with the steal. That wasn't her. That was Wysocki.
That was Wysocki. I believe Molly Tim Chatton's only in seventh grade, correct? Seventh grade.
Wow. Well.
So there's a future Cougar coming up. Ojeda for three, no good. Rebounded by Yarish, I believe.
It's tipped, and whoever that official is made the right call.
Kevin Fergal. He was up in the booth.
And now he's down on the floor fishing. He's everywhere.
He is everywhere. Wysocki with the ball.
He and DeVito must eat the same breakfast, man. They just appear.
Tim Chatton for three is no good.
Nice
inside
pass.
Nice pass. Wysocki missed the bunny there. And we're going to get a jump ball. Bobby, you think for Friday's girls game we could get on the floor maybe so we could see the jersey numbers, because I can't even see them at all, even for that one game.
Paul Bo, not happy with the designer of the Drums Tigers uniforms for the ladies, and they are really hard to see. They're not bad when everybody's standing still, but when they're in motion, it's really difficult.
And we're 30 yards away.
Yeah, we are. Three ball attempt. Easy, big fella. You can't see. This man takes great pride in his craft here, and it's difficult when we can't see the numbers. Outlet, I think that's Tim Chatton that runs it down. She's going to
pop a three, no good. Rebound by Williams. And a jump ball again.
It's Freeland having a tough time dealing with this speed.
and athleticism of drums early on in his first quarter.
Mid-range jumper, no good. Ball batted around. Barbolo tries to grab it into the hands of Lanier. Picked again from behind.
When Drums is up and down the court in
a
hurry.
They are so fast. The Chat dishes it off. The Chat again. Give her 10.
A little Euro step in there for the seventh grader. And we have a timeout.
Yep, let's take a quick break here, 30-second break. We'll be back.
In varsity girls action, Hazleton wins 67-61. They will play for the Wyoming Valley Conference Championship Saturday afternoon at 2 p.m. here in Hazleton Area High School.
All right, welcome back. Final 20 seconds. 14-point lead already. Freeman still looking to get on the board.
Just too much. Too much quickness so far. Another court awareness, a nice assist from Tim Chatton to Schaefer.
Yep. And there is your horn. And we are, one quarter is in the books here. Drums lead 16-0. Molly Tim Chatton with 10 points of the 16 for Drums. So, Coach, we've heard so much about Molly during the year, and she's as good as advertised.
Yeah, she sure is. She's got great control of the basketball, and it appears to me, I mean, I've only seen her for a quarter, but it appears to me that she's got a well above average understanding of the game of basketball. Just watching her dribble, drive, penetrate, she knows where other people are on the court. She's relentless defensively as well.
Yeah, absolutely.
Well, looks like we're going to be here 4 days straight.
Thank you, Christian.
Thank you, Christian.
Yeah, and Dallas plays, Dallas girls play later, so we'll get it, before we go off the air, we'll know who Hazleton's playing. Dallas is playing Lehman. We expect a rematch, round four of like the Rocky and Apollo Creed fight, huh? All right, four Drums, 16 points, 8 of 13 from the field. They're 0 for 3 from behind the arc. 3 turnovers, 3 rebounds, and 9 steals for Freeland. 0 for 6 from the field, 13 turnovers, 5 rebounds, and 1 steal. And when you're going against a team like this, Coach, you could play possession by possession, because that's how you have to do it. Freeland is obviously outmatched.
Yeah. I mean, you know, you want the girls to be as competitive as possible, but they're having a hard time getting some shots.
Nice high arcing shot.
And there we go.
Ojeda. And they say no basket, it hit the stanchion. I didn't think it hit it.
We didn't see it from where we're at, but they take that three-pointer away, and the Whippets, short-lived happiness.
Yep, Tim Chatton with the ball. Ball tipped around again. Nice jumper, no good. Rebound by Wysocki. Over to Schaefer. Now, see, Dave's daughter's easy. She has double ponytails.
Right.
I want to thank Dave again. Calling wrestling with him last night here. 2 nights ago. We had some Monday Night Raw wrestling. Williams drives in. Hard
nice
off the glass.
Job.
Up and in.
Nice give and go to get the Whippets on the board. Abby Williams with the put in.
And there's no such thing as a 16-point play, Coach. She's got to go. Three ball on the way is good. There's a steal again.
Reclaimed by Blanyar. Dribbles over to the right.
Good shot, got a good look. Williams runs down the loose ball, and Williams is playing a nice game.
She's got herself three or four rebounds.
Up ahead to some chat. Bends off a defender, up and in. Give her 15. Three ball on the way from the corner, no good.
Man, that looked good initially again.
Rebound by Schaefer. Up ahead. The Jatton drives. Running one-hander is good.
She's got 17.
Coach, I'm identifying these girls by their sneakers.
Okay.
Whatever we got to do.
Aurelius Casanova checks in for Freeland for Dereli Caraballo, who's going to have a seat.
Who we got coming in here for drums?
I believe Alicia Gonzalez, number 12. I believe maybe Mackenzie Castellans also, maybe. Trying to see the numbers. I think we have 10 and 12 out there. Charges two I identified.
Bounce pass over the corner, back over to Molly. Left wing, top of the key, Schaefer. Schaefer has it poke checked away. I got to get in one hockey reference tonight.
How about it?
Trying to get bullet pass inside at the doorstep. Missed the bunny. And a rebound by Williams, another one for her. And played a nice game on the boards. Chatting again.
3 seconds.
3:04 here to go in the first half. 23-2.
Tigers hanging out in the den a little bit too long. They got caught. 3 minutes until half.
Where's our halftime guest? They told him to start motoring, meandering up here.
Well, apparently they took you verbatim.
I see Yao Ming over in the corner over there. He's selling tickets for the Booster Club. I was talking to Mary over there. His wife, Mary, said Joey didn't sell one ticket.
Nice takeaway by Blanyar. She's harassed by Tim Chatton.
Here comes our producer, and he's loaded with food. He's taking advantage of Damian not being here, Bobby. Nice drive, and there's a foul. And
Molly's going to go to the line to shoot two. She threw it up, trying to get an old-fashioned three-point shot. But 2:27 left in this.
So, Coach, let's fast forward. A couple of years. And I probably won't be here. I'll probably be buried in Calvary somewhere. But anyway. When Molly Tim Chatton is a freshman.
Yes.
And this freshman class are juniors.
Yes.
That team's going to be something fierce.
Well, the potential certainly will be there. You'll have Baino. I'm assuming you're talking about the varsity,
yes.
Right?
Bindis.
You'll have Baino. You will have
Bindis.
You will have Marolo, excuse me, who are contributing very heavily now as freshmen.
Evelyn Schultz will be a senior. Legoli will be a senior.
So will Alexis.
Will be a senior, yep.
Yeah, that. Hopefully they'll still have us by then, Paul.
Well, I'm saying I'll probably be one with us.
Well, if you're not with us, I'm sure as heck not here.
I'm telling you, I'll be off the earth.
Yeah, well.
The way my nerves are. 25-2, 2 minutes to go here. We play. I'm watching DeVito. He got pizza. He got hot dogs.
He's got one of everything. What he went to ShopRite and bought pizza, hot dogs, wings. I think he brought half a steer up with him also. He might barbecue.
Nice rebound by Banier. Taps the brakes off the window. Can't get it to fall.
In and out. Nice job.
Rebound by Albertson.
By Aaliyah there. Just couldn't finish it.
Comes Schaefer. She taps the brakes. Can't get it to fall. Rebound by Albertson. And we're going to jump it with 1:37 to go in the first half. It's going to be Freeland ball, 1:31 to go. Nice crowd filtered in here for the second game here, Coach.
Yeah, it ended up filling up fairly well, at least on our side.
No, just off the rim.
It's going to be interesting to see if the finals are like they were last year,
oh,
because
man.
You could not, you literally could not get a seat.
No, I was happy for ours. Nice drive to the basket. I believe that is Wysocki that scored that. Her first two of the game. For Kayla. 54 seconds to go. That ball's tipped. And
we're going to get another jump. Possession. Staying with the Whippets.
Steal by Wysock. Oh, that's Schaefer on the steal, up and in.
Three ball on the way.
No good, 18 seconds to go. And Bobby, is Dave's daughter Anna a seventh grade also? Also a seventh grader, number 14, Schaefer.
Wow.
Ten seconds to go. Over to Albertson, back over to Schaefer. Schaefer behind her back. Kicks it back over Wysocki for three. That is short. There's your horn. So Drum scores 16 in the first, 13 in the second, a total of 29. Freeland gets on the board. We are at the half. It is all Drums, 29-2. Let's take a quick break. Supposed to have a halftime guest coming up. We're waiting for Scott Burkhart to make his way up here. And we'll be right back. Yep, we are back here at the half. My phone is blowing up for my guest there. This might be our highest rated segment ever. My good friend and yours and everybody's good friend. We coach Little League together. Know Scott all his life. I'm a little older than you, but we know each other a long time. One of the best guys around, Scott Burkhart. Scott, thanks for coming up in the booth.
Thank you, Polly Bo.
Now, you got big shoes to fill as Joe Veit was up here.
Yeah.
And we had Randy up here.
Yeah, I mean, I don't know how I follow that up with those two.
I don't know if we have, is he on? We're trying to get you on there.
Okay.
There we go.
Okay, I can hear you.
That's our high-tech equipment up here.
Yep.
So, Scott, you are the coach of the drums team. You're still coaching after all this time.
Still coaching, like, had a little hiatus and came back into it, yep.
It's like Elton John, I'm still standing.
That's it, yeah.
So tell us a little bit about the boys team here that we'll see tomorrow night.
To be honest with you, 4 years ago I coached and we won the championship here. And that team was really good. I didn't think I'd have a team like that again.
So who was on that team 4 years
ago? That was like Kyle Peters and Matt Bookman and Lanzinski. And Joey Marshall was a seventh grader at the time. But, yeah, we had a great team, and we ended up winning. And but this team, I told them, you guys are more talented than that team. From seventh to eighth graders, we have more talent on this team than that team did. And we're in fourth place. That just shows you how good these teams are right now. They have a good young program coming up.
So your team, you said Max Scatton's on your team?
Max Scatton, Cole Shiroki, and Aiden Tejada, and Max Tim Chatton, Gavin Nat. They're
That's
probably
John's son, right?
No, John's nephew.
Oh, John's nephew.
Yeah.
Okay.
So, yeah, that'll probably be our starting lineup. And they're really good. When they play and they make shots and they finish their layups, they're unstoppable. They can really play. It's just we haven't clicked yet with offense, defense. So hopefully tomorrow night will be that night.
So you guys are playing the Castle.
Yes.
How did you guys do during the year against them?
During the year, the first game, we got blown out. We tried to concentrate on their main scorer, and we kind of held him in check. But other guys just lit us up for other points and didn't realize they had other players. And they have a good team. They have a very good team. They dished the ball, the open guys, and they ran. They ran a lot. They got a lot of open baskets getting back. So the second game we played them was a lot closer. It was at the end of the year. It was the last game of the season. Didn't really mean anything standing-wise. So tried to play a lot of eighth graders.
Yeah.
But we were close in that game. I think we lost by 10 only. But we missed a lot of layups. And
they have young Mr. Macko on the team,
yes.
I see.
He's a real talent. He is. He's,
yeah, we
he's
saw him
player.
Last year playing for Freeland when Freeland had a nice team in here last year. And, you know, it's so nice. And you know, Rich is from the Williamsport area. Originally, he's from Monoy City, so he's originally from this way. Coached a long time. But, you know, we were so surprised last year because I haven't seen junior high basketball probably since my brother played. I mean, it's been a long time. And to see 2,000 people here last year for this tournament, it was just incredible.
Yeah, they get a great turnout. You get all four teams coming to watch the two games, and they'll stick around and watch the other game, the second game, and then you have grandparents and friends and other students coming and supporting the programs, which is great to see. You know, they need that, and that's what I tell the kids most importantly: go out there, give it 100%. And enjoy it. Take it all in. Look and see the crowd that you get to play in front of, the court that you play in front of, your name on the board. Enjoy that. Don't be nervous. The pressure's on them. They're the number one seed. We're the fourth seed.
Yeah.
Enjoy it.
And just the look on their faces. Rich said he was here earlier. The look on their faces when they saw the scoreboard.
Yeah.
You know, and just a big, huge thing here. And, you know, I saw Midge the other day. He told me we were going to see him here, but he's not here. Maybe tomorrow night. Maybe I'll for your game.
He's coming he doesn't want to come 2 days in a row and water it down. He wants to just come make his grand appearance, you know.
You know. Well, Scott, I know, like I said, you forever, and you're one for the kids, always for the kids. I'm going to tell a quick story here to Rich. He's never heard the story.
Okay.
So we're coaching Little League in the Hazel Little League. Shopee's not around now, so we can't get suspended.
We're okay.
Second game of the season. Okay, I believe Midge was umpire, was one of the umpires, if not the thing. So it was his fault. We're going to blame him. All right? Now, the two people that are going to get kicked out of the game first is going to be my first Hernes, then me. And then Scott will never get thrown out. Well, take a guess who got thrown out. Scott and myself both got tossed out of the game, and Hernes is sitting on the bench laughing at us. Yeah. And we won the game. We did win the game.
Yeah.
And Midge threw both.
Midge didn't throw us out. It was the other umpire. I don't know who he was. He was horrible.
Yeah, there was no leash there. They one thing I said and that I got thrown out. But the kid slid into third, and
base popped out.
We tug him out, and then he called him safe. I said he didn't get to the bag yet. The kid lifted his foot up and put it on the bag. I said, "Did you just see that? You're out of here." I said,
"There you go."
What did I say? I'm just saying, did you see what happened?
It was so funny. And like you were saying, Hernes was sitting there laughing. And then
we
got called into the principal's office by Commissioner Shopey. And he said, of all people that get thrown out of the game, you two.
Yeah.
About it.
Yeah.
We didn't even get suspended, though, because we were too valuable.
Yeah. I think we were coaching two teams at the time and being player managers and running the concession stand.
And this is 10 years ago. Because Jonathan was playing. Jonathan was, 12 years ago. Jonathan's 23 or 22. Yeah, and Scott's kids played. We had a great time. It was a great time. This guy, I'm telling you, he has the patience of a saint.
Nah,
I remember in T-ball with your team, they were like
his Zaners.
Team, Zaners, they were yellow, Rich. They were like bumblebees. So a kid would hit the ball. Caitlin played. Caitlin Bindis was 3 years old.
Yeah.
She was playing. His team would hit the ball and then run like bumblebees to the ball.
Oh.
And Scott was just standing
there. Swarm of them, yeah.
Well,
that's the hardest sport to coach is T-ball.
Oh.
I mean, you can coach any other sport. You throw Pat Riley or whoever and let him coach T-ball. He'll quit. He'll quit.
Oh, man, the times we had, Coach.
Well, I'll tell you what, any varsity coach worth his weight or her weight appreciates the job that the middle school and junior high coaches do because, and even the elementary coaches, because it's a feeder system. It should be like a roller coaster. Kids aren't getting scholarships. Well, most of them anymore aren't getting scholarships in seventh grade or eighth grade, but it's valuable when you put your system in, you learn the terminology. And I can tell you from when I coached, my most valuable assets were the junior high and Pop Warner coaches because without them, you have a very hard time winning on a consistent basis. So, brother, I appreciate you, even
absolutely.
Though I just met you five minutes ago. But anybody who coaches, these coaches out here in the middle school, they've got a yeoman's task because,
and
you know, it's the future of programs.
And the attention span on kids anymore. Is about 3 seconds.
Yeah.
And then after Scott was done coaching, I coached with Chris Tobias, another good guy. He's still up at the Little League doing stuff there. And our kids would be out there playing with their DSs.
there was great times and then some challenging times. But Pat Brogan, you have to give him credit.
Yeah.
He came down to all the games, all the kids' practices for all the gyms and, you know, said, hey, I want you to play man-to-man in the first half, second half. You know, let them learn how to play man-to-man. You know, let them, you know, push the ball up the court. Let them, you know, run the ball. And so he kind of, you know, is building the program that he wants to see and the kids that he wants to groom for that. So he's gonna have a really good ninth grade team. There's some really good eighth graders coming up, and I'm looking forward to seeing how they fare out.
Yeah, I know the Heights team has JJ's on their team.
Yeah,
we saw him, you know, last year here, and then obviously on the football field, we did the ninth grade games for football too. And, you know, and then Lopez that was on their team is another kid, a big kid. I think that's his last name, Lopez.
Yeah, and Aiden Tejada is a wide receiver for the football team.
Yep.
He's on the drums team. They're going to have a good football team, too.
They had a nice team. We did all their home games last year. And, you know, you talk about a feeder system. It was nice because we're doing the varsity games. So last year was the first year we did football here. We got to see the kids. You know, we got to see Austin Wilson play on the JV team and Johnson and, you know, all the kids that came up and made, you know, and made an impact.
Yeah.
It was nice to see them there. But, you know, I admire, like I said, Coach Bookman does a great job. I love Dennis, great guy. And Pat Brogan is such a good guy.
Yeah.
We know him forever, played here, was a fantastic ball player. And, you know, I hope everybody gets behind him and gives him a chance because it's not easy. And it's hard to play in a 6A, to coach in a 6A school because you're constantly, you know, I was looking at the standings today for 6A for the state. You got Roman Catholic. You have Lower Marion. You know, I mean, you played against Kobe.
Yeah. No, I didn't play against Kobe. I played against Daniel Marshall.
Marshall was the one. Yeah,
he's the only guy that I actually said, take me out of the game. I was running down at Martz Hall down the court. He just shot a three. Then he dunked one on the baseline on me. I said, How am I going to stop this guy? Take me out of the game.
Marshall, like, yeah. But, I mean, Lower Marion, Roman Catholic, yeah. Imhotep Charter, and 5A. It's all these Catholics, St. Joe's Prep, even their basketball team now. They're all these Catholic schools. They're recruiting kids from all over.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? They get the best of the best. Imhotep has a kid. He's 6'11". He's going to Connecticut.
Wow.
He lost three games all year. I was looking at the thing today. One to a team in Brooklyn, and I think two to two teams in Florida.
Wow. Well, you got to play better competition.
So Coach Brogan, like, doing a fantastic job. And, you know, Coach Gavio with the girls, we're happy with the girls. Like I said, they won tonight. We'll see them on Saturday. So.
Yeah.
All right, Scott.
Paul, it was a pleasure. Thank you.
Thank you, as always.
Nice to meet you.
Okay.
Appreciate what you do for the kids.
He's a great guy. One of the best. He's a fan of the Duke, the fossil. Oh, Scott's a great guy.
I'll tell you, those middle school coaches, they are so, so valuable to any successful program.
Yeah, like I said, Scott's one of the best. He has a heart of gold. For as big as he is, that's as big as his heart is.
When are you going to start bringing some rotten people up here? Because I'm telling you, everybody I've met, you know, everybody I've met, you can tell, has a heart and passion for kids and for these kids, and they care about programs, and it doesn't seem to me to be superficial.
Well, the worst guy you got up here is me.
Okay, so, well, there you go.
You can live with that. All right, let's go through some stats here. Drums, 11 of 22 from the field. Megan, 11 of 23, 1 for 7 from behind the arc, 2 for 2 in the free throw line, 8 turnovers, 11 rebounds, 13 steals for Freeland, just 1 for 14 shooting the ball. They've turned it over 20 times, and they're just playing possession by possession now. 7 rebounds, 4 steals, and they're up against a real tall task because it's now 31-2 here. The clock will start moving soon, Coach.
Right, and as you were reading the stats, Caitlin Carasquillo put in a short-range jump shot for the Tigers.
Yeah, I expect to see a lot of the girls who don't play as much play the second half.
Yeah, you would hope everybody on both teams gets an opportunity to get in and get some minutes. As I think we both know the outcome's decided here.
Yep.
But it doesn't mean that you can't continue to compete and have fun.
Nice and like, take there.
And like Coach just said, enjoy this. Take it in. Foul was on Abby Williams for the Whippets.
I believe that is Yarish on the line. First one is no good. Her dad, Jeremy, he's an official. Here we see him sometimes doing the JV games. We saw him doing a lot of football games.
He did.
And one of the nice, good up-and-coming referees.
Ball turned over by the Drums Tigers, I believe, off of Avery Stringent.
Lanier with the ball. Had a couple nice looks at the basket. Pops another three. This time she knocked it down.
Yeah, Blinder.
Nice shot by Aaliyah.
She's having a pretty nice game.
Yeah, the other one went in, but it was off the stanchion there.
Off the structure.
Stanchion. The structure is that thing that sits in the corner. Sometimes some people sit there, but it's usually not. Well, it's not there tonight. Williams with another rebound from the Whippets. Lanier coast to coast, lays it up and in.
Yeah, two possessions in a row for Aaliyah.
And that's what you want to see. You know, just some good things coming up the court. Like I said, the game's been long decided.
Yeah, you just want to keep competing. I mean, sometimes you play teams that are just better. There's no shame in losing as long as you're making the effort and you're doing everything you can.
The Freeland girls have not quit, not one bit. Not one bit. I'll tell you what, looking ahead, if everything stays the same for the championship game, Drums versus the Castle got some size.
Well,
they can handle Drums' quickness. I mean, obviously, they couldn't during the year, but it's a whole new time here. Playoffs and bigger court. And we'll see what happens. Williams gets another rebound and jump ball.
And maybe a little confidence, you know, from Castle, but that's why you play the game.
Tim Chatton with the ball, running the court. One on three, right to the rack, can't get it to fall. Ball tipped around. Back in the hands of Molly, steps back three, pops, good. Three ball, good, the other way, Ojeda.
Miss Ojeda lighting it up for the Whippets. Tim Chatton's shot short.
No way. Nice fadeaway jumper, just a little long by Blanier. 34-9 here. 2 minutes to 2 minutes 30 seconds to go in the third quarter. Whippets with 7 points in this quarter, best quarter to date. Three on the way is short. Blanier again on the breakout. Can't get it to fall. Coach, it's Valentine's Day. You're passing me notes. I'm getting worried.
I am. They're love notes.
Tim Chatton for three again. She's on fire. 25. And a foul.
And we're going to get somewhat of a line change for the Drums Tigers. Who have ballooned their lead to 30 points.
Been chatting on the line, and looks like it should be coming out after this play. And that is short. So we'll have to wait for the next whistle. Blanier again, showing the Jets. And she'll go to the line to shoot two. Foul on Yarish.
Yep.
And if you're looking at home and watching continuous clock running, that is because of the 30-point differential, if you're wondering. Now it stopped.
Well, it stopped for foul shots.
Well, it was running at the start of the foul
shot. That was Chubby running the clock.
Okay.
There's our good friend McKenzie down there, I see. Is that her down there?
That looks like her.
Yeah. And the other coach. My
freshman coach, yeah, my, of the girls.
Yep.
They should be trucking in here shortly, no?
Should they, well, they might stay and watch the Dallas game.
Okay.
I would. I don't know. Maybe they don't want to see any more of that team.
Well, I don't know what else they can see of them, and vice versa. This will be what, the fourth meeting on Saturday.
Yep.
I mean, I don't see them losing to Lehman unless they just have a real off night.
Lehman did have two girls hurt in that opening game that we did,
okay,
that did not play. So they do have a 1,000-point scorer. I know that. So hey, listen,
stranger things have happened, right?
That's why they play the games. Albertson inside, and she will be fouled. You know, we didn't get a chance to recap that game, Coach, and we will. When we go off the air, we'll go through that game.
First shot. Rims out off the backboard.
Albertsons. That one comes out also.
Possession is going to stay with Drums. As time runs down here in this third quarter.
Yep, final 10 seconds. Nice drive. Can't get it to fall. Albertson straight up goes Williams.
She's had a slew of rebounds tonight, Mr. Bow.
And there is your horn. 39 to 11 as we head to the fourth. Take a quick break and we'll be back. All right, welcome back here. Fourth quarter getting ready to start for Drums. They are 13 of 29 from the field, 3 of 13 from behind the arc, 2 of 7 from the line, 18 rebounds, 15 steals, and they turned it over only 9 times for Freeland. 4 for 27 from the field. They are perfect from the free throw line. They've turned it over 22 times, and they have 17 rebounds along with 4 steals. Good quarter for Freeland. Scoring 9 points in that quarter. 10-9, outscored by Drums. Nice pass to Albertson, and can't get it to fall. Williams, another board for Freeland.
Yeah.
Doing yeoman's work there. Glad you're going coast to coast and had it blocked.
Ball knocked away temporarily. We get a jump ball. Possession arrow with the Drums Tigers.
Schaefer with the ball as she brings it up the court. Behind her back she goes. Nice pass to Albertson. Wide open at the block. Lays it up and in.
Nicely done.
Payton's having a nice game.
Mm-hmm.
Doing the little things. That's her first bucket, but she's been around the ball.
Yeah, nice up and in.
Schaefer with that, give her 6. 3 ball on the way for Blanyard and no good. Williams, another board. 4 minutes to go. It's 43-11.
She's got to be close to double-digit boards on, total on both sides, offense and defense. And a quick officials timeout for a substitute into
Jaylen,
the game for
Jaylen
the Whippets.
Minnick lays that one in, her first points.
Casanova comes in. Caraballo has a seat. Nice rundown by Williams.
A nice 3, no good. Minnick with the breakout. Has it stolen away.
Lanier on a coast-to-coast run, Paul.
That's going to be a travel.
And substitutions back into the game for Drums.
Chatting back into the game, weaves her way. 2:43 to go.
And the Whippets are going to
empty the bench.
Empty the bench. Getting everybody an opportunity to play, which is awesome, but they can only have five on the floor, unlike.
Unless you're Scranton Prep and you're playing Williamsport. And that joke will never get old.
Nope. That's why I'll always point to you. You
Speaking
can
of Williamsport, Coach Cruz is going to be emceeing something at Penn College this weekend, I saw.
Oh, boy.
I asked him if he's getting in the ring. He said, the only time is when he's next to me. I told him he's the man.
Now, I would pay to see that.
What's that?
You and Coach Cruz going at it.
No. He said he was going to get in the ring and announce.
No, I'm saying.
Wrestle.
I would. Yes.
No way.
That would sell out.
Yeah, I'd be dead in a minute. Not even 30 seconds. The malfeasance would kick in. Nice shot. And that is Gonzalez, her first bucket. Long three. Oh, and the bank's open.
Way to go for Aaliyah Blanyar, I believe.
Yeah.
Give her doubles.
She's 10 to 14.
Yep. We are now under a minute to play.
And, Coach, don't forget, before we go off the air, we got to get our picture in the booth.
All right.
You and I, Christian and Bobby, DeVito will take it. Since he'll be eating.
Another three-ball miss, but collected and put in by Gonzalez.
Yes, second bucket of the game. 30 seconds to go here. And that is short.
More substitutes in. As Aaliyah Blanyar is going to have a seat, and she's played a whale of a game, so as Ms. Williams. And I'll tell you what, the score does not indicate the effort put forth by the Freeland girls tonight. And that's going to be the game. I don't know. Now, Paul, you have to refresh me on the rules here. Will she shoot or not?
She doesn't have to. But they might make her. They're going to let her shoot with no time.
Well, we know Freeland's going to end with 14 points. Points for Molly.
And that is your final score, 51 to 14. Molly Tim Chatton led the way with 29 points for Drums as they run their record to 17-0, and they will play the first game on Friday against the Castle.
They will, Paul, though.
And tomorrow we will be back here with boys action, Drums boys against the Castle, and the McAdoodle Mustangs will take on the Heights Terrace Hawks in a 2-3 matchup. Both games should be really, really good. Congratulations to the Hazen area girls for punching their tickets to the Wyoming Valley Conference Finals. A big win up in Pittston against Holy Redeemer, 67-61. They will be home on Saturday at 2 p.m., and they will play the winner of Dallas and Lake Lehman, who are playing as we are still on the air up there at Pittston.
And unfortunately unable to get any type of a score on that game to pass on to you.
Yep, all right, Coach. So let's do our thank yous here. I want to thank everybody here at the Hazel Area School District, Christian on stats, Bobby on the board, DeVito filling in for Damian, who's in Spain, and DeVito did a great job eating and producing. He did a fantastic job. We're going to get our Valentine's Day picture, Coach, before we go off the air. We'll have it posted on Facebook for everyone's comments. And for my partner, Rich Salonis, I'm Paul Bowe. It's a final score. The Drums Lady Tigers, 51. The Lady Whippets, 14. Be safe, everyone. We'll see you tomorrow night, 6 p.m. tip-off. Boys action, doubleheader again. Good night, everybody.